A very good morning to all of you. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today we will discuss dated 5 assignment key answers. Thank you so much. So the first question in the assignment paper, question number 1. For each item in column A, circle an item in column B that shows the opposite of it. Did you understand the question? For each item in column A, circle an item in column B that shows the opposite of it. So in column A, we have a tall tree. Okay? But we have to find the opposite of this tall tree. So in column B, we see there are two trees standing. One is tall and one is short. But we have to remember that we need the opposite of column A. So which is the opposite of column A over here? The shorter tree is this one. So you need to circle this one. So the second question that we have, for each item in column A, circle an item in column B that shows the opposite of it. So what is the item that we have in column A? It's a big hat, right? But what we need to circle? The opposite one from this one. So which is the opposite of bigger? Smaller. So which hat is smaller over here? We have to circle this one, right? Now we come with the second question from the assignment paper. Circle the lighter object. What do you mean by light? The lighter object. Okay, which has got less weight. Okay, so this is a feather. You have seen bird's feather or maybe peacock's feather. This is a feather and this is a stone. So when you hold both of them in hand, which is light and which is heavy? You can understand, right? Obviously, the stone will be heavier than the feather. So, which one you have to circle over here? Circle the lighter object. So, feather is the lighter object. Alright? Now, we come up with the third question from the assignment. Glass B is heavier. Is the statement true? Now you can see two glasses on the board. One is empty and one is filled with water. You can see this blue color? It is filled with water. You can try this at home as well. If you have two glasses, one should be empty and the other one should have water in it. Now hold it in your hand and check which one is heavy and which one is light. Obviously, the glass which is filled with water will be heavier than the glass which is empty. So over here, when we need to prove this statement, glass B is heavier, is the statement true? Yes, of course, it is true. So you need to write here, true. Okay? Now we come to the fourth question from the assignment sheet. Tick the longer rope. You can see this rope, right? One is longer, one is shorter. So you need to tick the longer rope. Which one is longer? Did you see this one? Right? So you can see which is long and which is short. You can take a pencil. You can take a new pencil. And you can take the old pencil which you already have sharpened it many times, right? If you take those two pencils, you will find which is longer and which is shorter. Same way, if you see this two rope over here, you will understand which is longer and which is shorter. But what is the question? Take the longer rope. So what we are going to take? Right? So this longer rope is the correct answer. So this is the last assignment for this dated. Tick the thicker object and cross the thinner object. object. This is the fifth question from the assignment sheet. Now you can see here there are two logs. Logs mean you have seen wooden log. The trunk of the tree, when it is cut, it forms log of wood, right? So over here you can see one thin log and one thick log. So what you have to do? Take the thicker object, that's the wooden log, and cross the thinner object, that's also the wooden log. So we have to take the thicker log. So I will take this because it's thick, and we have to cross the thinner log. So I will cross out of this. So here we end our assignment today. Please do it very carefully. It's very interesting. And after that, if you need any further assistance, contact your respective teacher. Thank you.